audible range of human ear is ultra 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz. About 20,000 hertz, it's called as ultrasonic means. Whereas below 20 hertz, it's called as infrasonic waves.
Terms related to sound are frequency and amplitude.
Amplitude is the maximum displacement of the wave, and frequency is the number of waves per second. And loudness is directly proportional to the square of amplitude. And higher the frequency, higher the pitch of the sound. High pitch sound is called shrill, and low pitch sound is called gruff. And vibrations are classified into wave fractions and compression. Compression is the compressed part of the sound waves, and wave fraction is the free part of sound waves. And noise causes high blood pressure and lack of sleep and lack of concentration also. It also leads to cardiac problems. And sound is classified into noise and music. Noise is unpleasant to hear, and music is very pleasant to hear and relaxing. Thank you.
Sound needs a medium to travel. Sound cannot travel through the vacuum. So sound definitely needs a medium and to travel, and air, water and solids are examples of the medium.
Hello everyone, my name is Akhilesh Bhula and I am from AP. So we did a project about mind mapping, about the chapter chemical effects of electric currents. Firstly, to test an electric current, we use testers, which are based on the effects of magnetic and heating effects. The liquids which conduct electric currents are usually acids and bases. These are known as electrolytes. Examples of such these are citric acid and tap water. Insulator is a distilled water, since there is no ions present in distilled water. So the chemical effect of electric current is electrolysis, which is the method used for electroplating and galvanization. These two processes are done with the help of electrodes. Example of using electroplating is gilt ornaments. This is where coating of metal with a superior one is done.
Prepared a lot of in flow chart. We have to